Okay, give me a break. We all gotta start somewhere. Hi, I'm Lee Aaron, but I guess you already know that. Here I am today, here to talk to you about my new album, Bodyrock. And I guess while I'm here, I'm going to tell you a little bit about my past history as well, just so you get to know me a little better. I wasn't that involved with the writing of my first album. I think I co-wrote 3 songs, but it did quite well for us, the first album. And it got a lot of attention in Europe. A magazine called Kerrang! Magazine printed a 2-page color pull-out poster of me, and all of a sudden we were getting all these phone calls because they wanted us to come over and showcase at the Marquee Club in London. Bango! We were on stage at the Marquee Club, and surprisingly enough, the reviews were great, and that's sort of how it all started over there for me. The Metal Queen record, that was my second album. The Molten album. We wrote one song called Metal Queen, and my manager got this big idea in his head. He goes, well, let's call the album Metal Queen. And the whole real gothic rock thing was really happening at the time, and so we just got blown out of proportion. We went off on this tangent of I ended up getting dressed up like Conan the Barbarian's wife, and we ended up doing this video, which, by the way, was a lot of fun. The only problem was when I walked down the street, people expected me to be 6 feet tall and be Amazon woman and have a loincloth and a sword hanging at my side. Metal Queen album ended up gaining us enough attention over in Europe that we got invited to come over and play the Reading Festival in, I believe, 1983. Don't quote me. So we went over, and we scraped enough money together to take the whole band over this time, but that was about it. We ended up sleeping on the floor in the flat of a gentleman that had written the original Kerrang! Article about me. He's since become quite a good friend. And eating peanut butter and jam sandwiches, and hey, but we got a chance to play in front of 60,000 people, and I guess that made it all worthwhile. But I guess that's what rock and roll's all about, you know, sleeping on floors and eating peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Call of the Wild album was the album that we ended up working with Bob Ezrin on, who is probably most famous for his work with Pink Floyd and Alice Cooper. And it was an interesting album. It was the first album that John and I wrote all the songs for, most of the material anyway. And one day Bob had come into the studio, and he played me this song, a rock ballad by some band out of Los Angeles. I guess it was never a big hit for them. And I heard the song and I flipped. I thought, gosh, this is it's a classic rock ballad. I know I can do a great job on this tune. And that's how we ended up recording Barely Holding On, and that spawned the video for Barely Holding On for the third record. In 1986, Attic Records signed me to the Virgin label outside of Canada, and we ended up doing the fourth record with Virgin Records, the Lee Aaron album, and I have to be honest, you know, and say that in retrospect, looking back now on that last album, artistically, I felt it was a little bit of a compromise for us because we'd written a lot of songs for that album, and I thought there was some great rock material on that record, but it got sort of lost in this real sort of slick, polished, sophisticated production approach. And I definitely feel that we lost a little bit of our edge on that record. Mind you, it was our most successful record to date, and we had a top 40 hit with Only Human, which was the first single, so what do I know? And now there's Bodyrock. We came off the road, the band came off the road in the end of 1987, and John and I, John Albini, who has been my co-writer and partner in crime for about the last 7 years, we went into intensive writing for this new record. And this time around, we really felt, you know, we've been through a lot of ups and downs in the last few years of our careers. We really felt that we wanted to make a record for us, something that came straight from the heart, no compromises, something that we could really be proud of and feel good about artistically. So we wrote, oh, somewhere between 50 and 60 songs for this new record. And when it came time to selecting producer, we had sort of two options. We said, well, we can bring in another big producer from the States or someone of a similar caliber who really doesn't know anything about me as an artist or what I'm really trying to aim towards as an artist. Or we can use our home team of people. Brian Allen, who is the A&R guy, he's also a great producer, who has been working on Attic for a few years now. And John Albini, my partner, recently built a studio in his basement, and our demos were just about sounding better than our last record. And I thought to myself, gee, this is crazy. You know, we have the talent, all the talent we need, and the technology to do it right here. So Brian and John formed a production team. We hired a great engineer. We did it here in Toronto. And I think the album sounds amazing. I'm so happy with this. I definitely think that the Bodyrock album is my best work to date. It's really what Lee Aaron is all about. When we wrote What You Do to My Body, we wanted to write a song that took more of a lighthearted, humorous approach to love and sexuality. And that's sort of how that song came about. When it came time to do the video, we really wanted to do the same thing. And it was very important to me this time around to have a video that I felt appealed to women as well as men. So, of course, the first idea that came into my head was, let's hire some really nice looking guys. Anyway, none of my girlfriends complained. They were all phoning me the next day and they said, can we come down and watch the video shoot? It was great fun doing that video though. What I've been telling everyone, I think it combines a perfect combination of sex, humor, and rock and roll. Humor being the new element. So, enough talk, let's watch. From my new album, Bodyrock, this is the video for the single, What You Do to My Body. I hope you have as much fun watching it as we had making it.